Good day, friends. It is me, HLModTech, and I am back with another Tinkercad tutorial. So let's get cracking. Friends, today we've got another cool suggestion by a user. They want a reduction from 8 centimeters down to a rectangular shape like this. Friends, let's see if we can build it in Tinkercad. Of course, step one is create new 3D design. Let's start by naming it. We're going to call this Vent Reduction. And it's going to also end with a rectangle. Looking back at the image, I know that this was 8 centimeters, and I know this is a rectangular shape. The rest is all pretty flexible. I'm going to show you a technique, and then you can get your numbers absolutely perfect. I'm going to start by bringing out a cube, and what this does is it gives me a face to drop the tube on. Now, when I drop this tube out here, I know I need a radius of 40 to get that 80 that the user wanted. But I think that 80 includes the walls, so I'm going to type 42 so that way it's larger. I also like to quickly make it fully round by bumping up the sides. And then I'm going to make the wall thickness 2, so that way it's sturdy enough for 3D printing. Now if we click on this, we can do D for drop. And you can see that's aimed the way it would attach to the device. Now let's quickly check the measurements with the ruler. If we bring this out and click on the shape, you can see that that is 84. That means the inside is 80, which should slide onto the user's vent pipe. Of course, that involves a tiny bit of math, but hopefully you can handle it. Now you can pick how much of this you want to print. I'm gonna go 30 millimeters. I think that'll be plenty sturdy. I'm gonna move this to the side. And now, friends, let's make that rectangle. Now, once again, I do not know the exact measurements, but I do know a cool tool that'll work if you have measurements. If we type soft, we can grab the soft box, and because of cruising, bam, I can stick it right on that cube that was helping us line things up. Let's say you wanted it to be 200, press enter, and it snaps to 200 in X. Now that's stupid large for the piece we had, because remember it was 80. I'm gonna go back to 110. That's probably more reasonable for what the user wanted. And then I'm gonna go a Y of, let's say, 35. I want that wall to be 2, just like it was on the other. And then I like this radius of 6. I think that is pretty nifty. If we click down on the ground, we can now select our shapes, do a line, and if we choose middle, bingo, those parts are lined up. All right, so if we look back at the design, I'm gonna move this out a little bit. As you can see here, we've got a trapezoid, and they did this with a wedge. I'm gonna do it with a half sphere. Let me show you how this works. So first, let's nudge this out just a little bit. Then let's search for our trapezoids. There are several to pick from, and the one I want is a double trapezoid. I'm gonna spin the world so I can see this better, and because of cruising, I can set it right on that shape. I'm gonna click back down on the ground. Let's do D to drop, and then let's type in the parameters. I'm gonna try 110 for the base width. Let's see if it's that measurement that goes that way, and yes, it is. So now that'll line up exactly with the edges. Let's see if we can get this to merge pretty good with our shape here. Let's try a 90. So it'll be a little larger than our 80. That's looking pretty sweet. Let's make that height 70. See how far that stretches back out. That was plenty far. Let's try instead 55. Notice these red lines mean Tinkercad is figuring out those dimensions. Make sure you're patient. Also, make sure you do not drag the handles, because those break the parameters. While I'm waiting, remember this is going to be 35, so let's go back here and make the base length 35. And then I'm going to make the top length 30. I think that'll be a nice taper. Now if we hit D for drop, that shape drops in. As you can see, it connects pretty well. I'm going to just use the arrow keys to bring it back. And then to make this one connect, I'm going to do W for work plane, and I'm going to just hit D for drop. So now that is connected. I'm going to put the work plane back down on the ground. We are going to use the half sphere. Now when you bring it out, because of cruising, we can set it right on that edge. Boom. Now remember, we know the measurement of this is 84, so I'm going to just do a shift stretch and then type 84. Because we're holding shift, it scales to that spot in every direction. Now I'm going to grab the two, press L for align, click on the orange one to make it the boss, and we want to bring it all the way down to the bottom. And then if we look at it from the back, it's real easy to see that is where the center would be. So now our shapes are combined. We can take this shape and adjust it to be however you want to get the amount of airflow going in there that you think is cool. It looks like I clicked something and I lost my measurements. Let's get those back real quick. Although they look fine, they just snapped. So let's just type one of these again. 30 and press enter. I'm going to change this to 88 just because I think it could have been a little thinner. There, it snapped back to where it was. I have never seen that happen before, but as you can see, if your numbers are still there, it's pretty easy to adjust. Let's even try this at 84 so it actually comes to this outside edge, since we know that is the measurement. That's pretty slick. So now let me show you how we're going to hollow this out. Select your half sphere, do Control D, make that second one a hole. We're going to hold down shift and we're going to shrink it from 84 down to 80. Now we want it to cut out, so we're going to pull it towards us with the arrow keys. You can see right there it will cut that out. We are going to shift select and grab the pink one as well. Do align, and we do want to make sure that the pink one is the boss, and we go to the center, and we already had this center. Now we're going to do essentially the same thing out here. Control D, make that second one a hole, and then this one we're going to take away 4 from each of these. So instead of 110, it's 106, 31, 81, 26, and 51. And then we do need to nudge it towards us with the arrow keys until it pokes out. So you can see right there, it pokes out. I'm gonna go an extra one or two out because I wanna make sure it does not cut into this orange one. Friends, with those pieces in place, select those. Notice I'm skipping the yellow one, and let's do Control G to group. And when we look inside, we are so close. Let's ungroup this super quick and make sure we fix that. I'm going to click on this hole, and I just want to stretch it back that extra couple millimeters. So now it gets past. Once again, friends, when we grab those three shapes and the holes, total of 5 shapes, we group it, and bingo, you have got your duct. How cool is that? Now, I am not tremendously picky, so I would probably print it like this, but friends, if you want to try and get rid of those corners, if you search for Meta, M-E-T-A, you will find the Meta Fillet. Now I'm gonna bring this little dude out and I'm gonna cruise him on that corner. I know I want a 6 radius because that's what we typed back when we built this guy. And we can even click back and double check that. And then I'm just gonna nudge this into place with the arrow keys. I've got it set. I'm going to set it to 0.1, and I'm going to do shift nudge to get it close. There's control down to get the height right. Let's do F for fit view. Of course, it's going to be a hole. You can see how that's going to cut through there in a second. And then I'm just eyeballing it down into that space. There are some control downs and overs until I've got it in the exact spot that I want. I think that is going to be pretty close. And then when we change the height of it, We can use those shift arrow keys to nudge it back so it is ready to cut. I'm going to do Control D, shift nudge to the other side. Notice if I set this back to 1, that shift nudge goes way faster. And then I'm going to use the mirror tool to flip that. Then let's do the F to fit view to get over there. Now I will get more precise. Same tricks, just that 0.1 and nudge it over. Notice this time the height was already pretty good. I think I'm going to be happy with that. I'll do F to fit view on the yellow one so we can see everything. And then friends, if we shift select our two pieces, the fillets, and do Control D and D for drop, we can simply mirror those and they are in place as well. Once again, if you want to double check your measurements, you can. This may look cooler if we stretch it all the way out past. That way the cut follows all the way through it. And one final grouping, Control G. How cool is that? Now as I wrap up, friends, just a few things about Tinkercad I love in the settings. You can pick an awesome background color. I'm gonna choose a blue for Michigan. Then you can also shut off the grid, which looks cooler for screenshots. I will remind you that you can export it as an STL right over here. And then finally, Tinkercad saves to the cloud as soon as you click the dashboard. Your design shows up in your gallery and it's totally private, but friends, watch this. If you click on it and change your properties, of course, make sure it has a cool name. You can fill out a description, of course. Mine says tutorial is coming soon. Give it some tags. I added vent and round to rectangle vent. Friends, if you want me to see what you make, if you type HLMT23, I search that tag almost every day, and of course, I'll give you a reaction. Finally, if you want the world to see it, make it public. And I always choose attribution, no derivatives, because I want you to come up here, follow that tutorial, and gain some epic skills. Of course, complete the CAPTCHA, and let's hit save changes. After you do that, friends, if you click on the gallery, initially you'll see all the staff favorites. But if you shut off staff picks, you will see all the latest designs that have been created. If you click over here, you can switch to see many, many more designs. It looks like somebody's classroom is making trees. Those are absolutely awesome. This is what I mean by giving a reaction. If you see something that people are making, you can tell them, wow, that's fantastic. Oh my gosh, love the Mark 9 Fusion. That is awesome. And also, check out the exam. That is so darn cool. I'm gonna give it a wow. And when you hit view in 3D, after a moment, it'll load and you can check it out from every angle. Wow. Mine has not popped on this page yet, but let's check out that HLMT23 tag. HLMT23 and press enter. You can see there are tons of cool designs in here. And as promised, when you send me one, I always give you a reaction. I also want to shout out this house day one. It is so cool when you're completing my tutorials and you let me know about it. And finally, there is my vent reduction. Of course, friends, those reactions are appreciated. Friends, as I wrap up, I just want to remind you about my website, HLModTech.com. I've got a tab dedicated to Tinkercad with tons of awesome categories. And then below that, you can find my day one favorites and also useful starters. And then finally, the Tinkercad essentials. Friends, also at the bottom corner, I want to share the sweet built-in messaging tool. You can click that button, add your question, comment, or suggestion, and reach me almost instantly. Lastly, friends, don't forget the Tinkercad Community Discord. As you can see, we've got more than 700 members, and it is a fantastic place to talk everything Tinkercad. Finally, friends, if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. Please also hit that share button so more people can learn about HLModTech. Of course, friends, don't forget you absolutely make my day if you take time to leave a comment down below. And if you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Smash that subscribe button, and last but not least, hit that notification bell if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new video from me. HLModTech. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.